In this video, I will show you how to hide rows with Google Apps Script. We have a to-do list and we want to tick these boxes and have a cleanup menu that we can choose so that we can hide these rows. In order to make this work, we have to write a little script. We're going to name this project cleanup, but you can name it whatever you want to. The function we're also going to call cleanup, but we have to make sure to reuse the camel case writing, so the C is small and the U is uppercase. The very first thing we're going to do is access our active sheet. So we need to get that active sheet from our spreadsheet app object. And then the second step is to get our data. And we will be using the getDataRange method to do that. That is my preferred method. And it gets me back the range that contains data. And then we're going to read the values from that range. It's going to give us all of our content of our sheet. Once we have that data, we're going to loop over it. We're going to use the for each method to do so. Again, this is my preferred way. The row that you see there is each row as we loop through our data. And we're going to say, if the row, so the second position in the array, index 2, if that is true, meaning if the box is ticked, then do whatever is written in this block in the curly brackets. Here, we will also be needing our index to know which row we're looping on. You'll see why afterwards. Now, let's dive a bit into that row 2, so index 2. That's this here. So in an array starts at 0. So, whoops, wrong. Row 2 will be whatever is undone. So we're saying if in row 2, so if a checkbox is ticked, then do whatever is here in this code block. So now we're going to write the code that will be executed if the checkbox is ticked. And we're going to get the range. So we need to find out which range is, or which row is ticked. For that, we're using the getRange. We're using the index to find out on which row am I, and we need to add the plus 1 because this method requires the number of the row and not the index, which would be 0. And then we're going to use the hide row method, and we need to pass in the range. That's why on line 7 we got our range. Now let's save all of that. So that is the code you need to hide the rows. And now we're going to write the onOpen function. So this is to be able to choose this function, this script from our menu. And to do so, we get the spreadsheet app, the UI, so the user interface in Google Sheets, and we create a menu. Now, this is up to you how you want to name this menu. I've called it Cleanup. And on that menu, we're going to add a menu item of hide row. And whenever you click on that, guess what's going to be executed? Exactly, the cleanup function we just wrote before. By the way, I like to add the onOpen as the very first thing in my script, as it will be read from top to bottom, and it's a little bit faster than if it were at the bottom of our script. So let's go back into our sheet. We're going to refresh this file that will trigger the onOpen method or function that we wrote before. That means that next to help, we'll see our custom menu popping up in a couple of seconds. There you go, cleanup. If we click on it, choose hide row. Since it's the first time running this, we have to authorize our script. Just follow along like so, choose your account, scroll down to allow. And this has now halted our execution, so we have to run it again. And there you go. And let's take a new box, cleanup, hide row. There you go. Super easy, super fast. I want to share a sneak peek with you. Next week's video is about how you can create a make a copy link for a Google Sheets file. If you don't want to miss out, then go ahead and subscribe to this channel because every week we publish new video tutorials about Google Sheets, AppScript, Gmail, and so on, and I don't want you missing out on them.